We are here on day one of Star Wars Episode 7.
You're here.
How incredible is that?
In 1977, George Lucas introduced the world to the phenomenon of Star Wars. Since then, the saga he created has become a staple in the world of modern entertainment. On December 18th, 2015, the long-awaited newest addition to this film series finally premiered. Star Wars Episode 7, The Force Awakens. The Star Wars films have forever changed the science fiction genre, and have since become some of the most iconic films of pop culture. Those who saw the original trilogy first premiere, starting in 1977, describe the initial impact the movies had upon their initial release.
I just remember it was just always a part of my world. I remember Return of the Jedi, so that was 1983, I was about five. And it was just a big part of everything.
I think when it came out that most people that watched it really enjoyed it, but nobody really understood exactly the impact that it would have over time.
Well, I probably didn't see my first one that I can remember probably until maybe early 80s at that point. So maybe I'm 7, 8 years old. But I felt like at that time and then from that time on up until, you know, 20 or so, that it did have that impact, like right away. By the time the second one came out, I think it was already bigger than just the two movies.
Being the seventh installment in the series, The Force Awakens is the first film produced by Lucasfilm to take place after the original trilogy, which concluded with Episode 6, Return of the Jedi, in 1983. This film follows new protagonists, Finn, a reformed stormtrooper, and Rey, a mysterious girl with a strong connection to the Force. Along the way, they work with other new faces as well as some iconic characters whose returns have been long awaited. Together, they fight against the deadly First Order as part of the Resistance. After waiting for so long, many fans have different opinions on the movie that restarted the Star Wars saga.
I was very excited to go. Part of what was so much fun was I got to take my daughter, who's now into this. So it was nice to share that with her. I felt like it was a return to the movies from my childhood.
I thought it was a good representation of what the old movies were, but it was unique enough that it could be a good movie in its own right.
I loved it. It was literally like one of the best movies I've seen in a long time.
The Force Awakens introduced a whole new generation of heroes and villains to the Star Wars universe. The new cast had a lot of expectations which they had to uphold. Movie and TV critic Matt Zoller Seitz discussed the new characters in his movie review on RogerEbert.com. He praises the archetypal new cast that reinvigorates the series. The film stars Daisy Ridley as Rey, John Boyega as Finn, Oscar Isaac as Poe Dameron, and Adam Driver as the evil Kylo Ren. Fans were very anxious to meet these new characters, hoping that they could meet their expectations.
I like them all. It's nice to see a girl at the focus for a change. I think that they can stand on their own. I think if you took everybody else out, the originals, you could have these new characters stand on their own and hold a movie on their own, which is nice to see.
The new characters, I thought they were pretty well developed, or at least most of them. They seemed to work well together.
Along with the new ensemble, fans of Star Wars were also treated to the long-awaited return of many famous and iconic characters. Harrison Ford and Carrie Fisher reprised their roles as Han Solo and Princess Leia Organa. Actors Anthony Daniels and Peter Mayhew also came back and donned their costumes once again to play the roles of C-3PO and Chewbacca, respectively. Mark Hamill, of course, also returned to play the original hero of Star Wars, Luke Skywalker. Seeing and hearing all these familiar actors brought back a certain nostalgic feeling to viewers.
It was great. I loved it. It's not Star Wars to me without those characters. And I know sooner or later I'm going to let them go. But to me, Star Wars will always be, it might be my age and my generation, will always be those three original characters.
Yeah, I felt like they were really well introduced, and then they didn't put too much of a focus on them in the film, which I thought was good because it should be its own movie. So the newer characters, I think, should take precedent.
Something very important that movie critic Seitz touched upon in his review of the film was the way that the main cast differs from those of either previous trilogy, giving the main action protagonist roles to a female and a man of color. This is something very different that brought about many varied opinions from the fans.
I think socially it reflects a lot of changes that are going on in the United States, and as a mother of three little girls, it's nice to see a girl that they can latch onto who isn't a princess and pink and poofy. That's nice.
I don't think that they were necessary for that to happen, but if that happened and the movie's great on top, then I guess it's a winner all the way around.
I don't know that it really made a difference. I mean, I like the characters, but I think because the movie itself is based on a lot of different alien races. You didn't have black and white, but you had other races that were portrayed through there. So I don't think it had a huge impact on it. I don't know. To me, I like both of the characters. I thought the actors that portrayed them were really good. You know, so I don't know that it made that much of a difference.
The Force Awakens has shattered box office records. Having been released on December 18th, 2015, the film has already grossed more than movies such as Titanic and Avatar. Within 20 days of its initial release, Episode 7 had already earned the title of the most successful movie in North America, not accounting for inflation. It's since broken many domestic records as well, and is on its way to winning many global ones. The film has a lot to which it can attribute its success.
I think quality filmmaking. I think there was a real sense that these were going to be good quality things, a respect for what was originally done.
Generations, you know, I'm 60, so you know, people that were, you know, 10, 8, 10 years old who were big into it then, who have grown with it, who have had children, and they've told their children about it, and their children have watched the Star Wars movies coming up. So I think it's just kind of snowballed because of that. It has a developed following that passes through many generations.
Introducing new characters, as well as bringing back many beloved faces, Episode 7, The Force Awakens, has truly kick-started a whole new age of Star Wars. Director J.J. Abrams has both reinvigorated the series, as well as paved the way for Episodes 8 and 9 directors, Rian Johnson and Colin Trevorrow, respectively, to further expand upon such a beloved universe. Fans have already fallen in love with this movie, as well as the fun, excitement, and joy that comes with it, and they happily look forward to the next two sequels. I'm Ben Curwin with Monthly Rewind Season 20, and I'll see you next time.